We have an audience which is really desirous of music with an incredible shit detector, very little time and only time for the best. We have an archaic apparatus saying buy an overpriced album, most of which is not good, pay a lot for it, pay a lot to see the band. This is a disconnect with the audience. And as a result of GarageBand and all the other technological wonders, anybody in this room can make music, make song in 5 minutes and put it up on iTunes and say, buy it. So there's more music than ever before. So it's completely confusing, which brings me back to the point, the person who's going to make all the money is going to be the filter, who's going to tell you what to listen to. Okay? But we were living in an era of chaos. We've moved past Napster, the concept of stealing, music being free, and the major, that's all in the past. What we're going to is, okay, how important will music be in the culture? Will it drive the culture again? You know, one of the big things reading about this just before I came down here is, you know, are you breaking release date? That's about money. That's not about music. Okay, because a good record lasts forever. So the concept becomes, how can we make great music, get it to the audience, get paid for it? And the people who are going to make those decisions are not the people in power. Except maybe on the touring end because they control buildings, a lot of money, but all the labels, all the creation, that's in the hands of you, waiting for you to revolutionize it. Don't knock on the door of the usual suspects because they want to make the payments for the private school and the Mercedes in the house. Their interests are completely divergent to yours. So it's in your hands.